I am troubled by the cost and the delay associated with the increase in litigation that we've seen over the last couple of years. The whole purpose, or at least one of my purposes, in working with Senator Leahy on the Open Government Act and creating the Ombudsman Office was to help informal resolution of any misunderstandings about either the scope or the nature of a request for documents. That was based, I think we've had this conversation before, on my experience when I was Attorney General of Texas, that many times people not familiar on how to navigate government, they may make a request that's broader than they really want, or they may be directing it to the wrong person. And the whole idea was to, way before any kind of adversarial process is created, to just create a more of a culture of customer service, for lack of a better term. And I think that's part of the cultural shift that has not yet occurred here in Washington, D.C., but hope springs eternal. Ms. Nesbitt, the response that you made, I believe, to about the D.C. Circuit Court alternative dispute resolution for these cases, of course, you know, and Ms. Puste knows that the purpose was to prevent litigation in the first place, if possible. And so it doesn't seem satisfactory to me to say that the court is a docket management tool, has instituted a pilot program to deal with, to mediate these cases. How do we prevent them from getting to the court in the first place?
I want to be sure you understand that I was not suggesting that the D.C. Circuit is a solution. Rather, it's a great indication that they think mediation should be working in FOIA cases.
In this case, I agree with the D.C. Circuit Court.
Yes, I do too. I think it's a great start. And so it's a model. It's also an incentive, I think, to agencies to know that if a lawsuit is filed against them, certainly in the D.C. Circuit, and I understand there might be other circuits to do the same thing, and they're going to be directed immediately to mediation, that is an incentive to do it earlier. It does take a culture change. It is going to take time, but certainly the dispute resolution skills training that we teach, that the Office of Information Policy participates in with OGIS, is aimed at giving people in the agencies the skills they need to be able to better communicate with requesters, to prevent those disputes in the first place, and become much more comfortable with exactly the kind of give and take that you are pointing to and that can make a difference and can head off litigation, so that we don't have somebody having to file a federal case,
right,
just because they can't get they can't have a communication with the agency about what they're looking for and when they're going to get it.
I don't have any statistics at hand, but I would imagine that the number of people, or the percentage of people who actually file lawsuits, is a much smaller number than those who make FOIA requests in the first place. And of course, lawsuits are expensive, and so it seems to me to be an inadequate remedy. I know you're not suggesting otherwise. To provide for mediation at the circuit court. Are there other tools that that you believe that are needed? In other words, do Senator Leahy and I and the committee need to look at additional reforms aimed at preventing litigation or otherwise resolving these disputes more quickly?
Well, I do think the amendments from 2007, the Open Government Act, was really an innovation, and it is going to take time. I think support from this committee, support from the House as well, for this kind of approach and really encouraging it and encouraging agencies to do it, is going to continue to go a long way. It does require a change in thinking. It requires a change in approach. But I think agencies are receptive to that, and we're just going to keep at it.
I know patience is considered a virtue, but in this instance, it seems like we waited a long time since 2007, and I would just ask you or any of the other witnesses or people in the audience who are interested in this topic to please send to me and Senator Leahy, Senator Franken, and the committee any other suggestions you may have, because the litigation expense alone is something that seems like we would want to avoid in these times of sequestration and concerns over our fiscal condition here at the federal government. But
yes,
in terms of getting people access with minimum hassle, minimal expense, mm-hmm. and just because it is something I think we're going to have to change in terms of the attitude to one of, as I suggested, customer service,
yes.
one where this is an obligation of government officials, not a nuisance to be tolerated, which I fear so often is the attitude. Thank you very much.
Thank you.